morning, Arthur.
Could use a slug of whiskey in this.
Maybe after lunch, hey?
How are you? Covered from that business in the hotel?
Oh, yeah. So we gonna hit that bank I told you about?
We'll see. You did good in town, finding out about that train.
Thank you. It was fun.
Well, I wouldn't say it was all fun. Oh, hey. Okay, I'll catch you later then.
Sure thing.
Starting to look like home.
It's taking shape.
Good work, Miss Grimshaw.
Here we are.
Oh, Lord, please end it.
Speak. Don't cry, boy. Speak about your gang.
I can't.
Boy.
Whoa, hold your horses there. It seems the cat has got our friend here's tongue. I was thinking Mr. Williamson could have a word.
You ready to talk, boy?
I told you, mister. I told all of you. I don't know nothing, okay? They ain't no friends of mine. I just been ridden with them for a while.
Horseshit! You see, we heard that part, so how about you tell the truth?
That's what you want me to do.
Hurt him, so the next time he opens his mouth, it is to tell us what is going on!
Who am I kidding? One of O'Driscoll's boys couldn't open his mouth, but he'd tell a lie. Screw it. Let's just have some fun. Geld him.
Oh, yeah!
What's he doing? Where's he going?
Oh, don't worry. You're only balls, boy. Just gonna cause you trouble. You know, in Imperial Rome, eunuchs was among the happiest and most loyal of courtiers.
No, you're kidding me, right?
Of course.
You sick bastard! Oh, what do you want from me?
Well, you are gonna talk. The only question is now or after we got these little fellas off.
Okay, listen. I know where O'Driscoll was holed up, and you're right. He don't like you any more than you like him. He's at Six Point Cabin. I'll take you there. Serious, I don't like him. I mean, I like him even less than I like you, no offense.
Oh, none taken.
Okay then, partner. Why don't you take a few of us up there right now? I got this, Dutch. Should be fun. All right, you. Come on. Let's go.
Gild him.
Let's both hope you ain't trying to trick us, O'Driscoll.
I ain't no O'Driscoll.
You sure as shit was.
John, Phil, come here.
We got a social call needs making. Where are we heading?
We're up into the hills behind Valentine. I'll show you.
John, you take this little rattlesnake with you. Any nonsense, kill him. You're gonna pay your buddies our respects.
He taking us to Cone?
That's what he says. Come on.
I'm taking you to him. Look, I'll give you more directions when we're close. But if I know where we are, it's up past Valentine.
All right, I'll leave. What was that, huh? Sharing saddle with an O'Driscoll. Who'd have thought?
How many times I gotta say? I ain't an O'Driscoll.
You sure look like one, and you smell like... God damn. You smell like one, too.
I smell like horse shit.
That's right. Boy, are you high.
Morgan! You got throwing knives in your saddlebag. Dud said that you might... I was asked to give them, and I'm doing you the further courtesy of telling you about it.
Next time you want to give me something... How about you give it to me, instead of hiding it somewhere, hoping the opportunity comes up to mention it?
Last goddamn favor I do you.
Hey. Hey. If I got my bearing. Take this track up through the rocks.
How you holding up, John?
Fine. Still ain't right, but I'm fine.
You damn well should be after all that bed rest.
Hey, all right. Abigail wouldn't let me up. You know her. She won't be reasoned with.
Well, when you was having a failure of reason and hiding behind your woman, we were getting shot at.
And I'd do the same for you, if you was in a bad way.
I hope so. But I fear you don't know how to help anyone. Except in yourself.
See, O'Driscoll? If this is how he treats his friends, imagine what he does to his enemies.
I got an inkling of what you all do to your enemies when you put those gelding tongs to my parts.
Bill, you still got those tongs?
I got a knife. Won't be so clean, but it'll do the job.
Keep that in your mind, young feller. Right at the forefront of
it. I swear, I promise, I am taking you to Combe as best as I can. You'll see, I'll make good.
Save your horses, we gotta climb. Boys,
you know, you all ain't that different from the O'Driscolls.
What did you just say?
I've been watching you all these weeks, and,
you've been tied to a tree. You don't know nothing about this gang.
Yeah, well, I'd say you don't know much about the O'Driscolls. But maybe I know more about you than you know about them. And I know all about them, so...
Tell us then. How are we like those mongrel dogs?
You're outlawed like them. You're out to survive like them. You live rough. You live hard. Fighting the law, nature. You're out for yourselves.
See? This is why you're an O'Driscoll, O'Driscoll. You're out to survive. We're out to live. Free. Colm's a sneak thief and a killer. Dutch is more like a teacher. Hey, watch it.
From where I've been, you just look the same as all.
Then you looked, but you ain't seen.
John, shut that boy up.
Enough out of you.
Boys, we're almost on them. Now, who knows if this son of a bitch we got with us is talking true, but if it's what he says it is, and Combe O'Driscoll's here, we can end years of fighting. Here and now.
Okay, now cut left up here. We go down the hill into the forest.
We're going in quiet. Taking them out as we find them. Trying not to set things off. But if we do, we move quick and hard. We settle this like we know how, okay?
Okay. By me.
With you, Morgan.
All right, then.
Through the trees here. Hey, we're real close. I'd leave your horses the other side of this clearing.
I'll get my guns off my horse, and I'm ready.
Easy, Bill. Quiet.
This is it. The cabin's just the other side of this hill.
Okay. Off your horses. Let's go.
You gonna get them knives?
Easy.
Follow me, all right? It ain't far.
We might have shared a horse, but we ain't friends. Remember, I'm watching you every moment.
I ain't gonna shop you now. Come on. It'd be suicide.
You'll die, boy. But you'll lose your balls first.
Jesus Christ. Hey. There. There. You see?
Okay. Get down.
The cabin's in the clearing down there. There'll be a bunch of fellas hiding out there, too.
Are these fellas armed?
Armed? Drunk? Wary of strangers, yep.
And Cornwall Driscoll?
Well, he'll be holed up in his cabin. Be passed out, booze blind, likely as not.
And over there, someone's coming.
So, who's gonna tell him we ain't got nothing for the pot?
Oh, let me think. The fella that spooked the game, I reckon.
I'm gonna drain it. I'll catch up.
No, we ain't gonna fall for that. We're gonna wait so you can tell him yourself.
Yeah.
If anyone's actually gonna shoot the messenger, it'd be that mean son of a bitch.
Yes, sir.
Come on, shake it off.
Come on. What are we doing about the pisser, Morgan? One by the tree.
Let's get closer. I'm gonna deal with this first fella.
Okay, go to work.
The old man loses it. I won't get another chance in ages. I'll be stood guard duty. Sun up to sun down. Soiling my drawers in the spot.
Hey, he's down.
Hands in the kitchen!
Yes, they know we're here.
What are we doing about the pisser, Morgan? One by the tree.
Let's get closer. I'm gonna deal with this first fella.
Okay, go to work.
Hurry up already.
To. What's the plan?
We're waiting. Just you tell me, where you want a new hole?
Good, Morgan!
Yes, they know we're here. Let's get him!
Been riding with Dutch for years.
You're worthless.
None of them get out of here.
What are we doing about the pisser, Morgan? One by the tree.
Let's get closer. I'm gonna deal with this first.
Okay. Go to work. The next two. What's the plan?
Keep back where they won't hear us. When I move, you move. Take them out at a distance.
I can do that.
Sooner we get this over with.
Get to it, then.
Right up there. He's meek as a little lamb.
He better be.
Arthur! Feller on the log. What are we doing about him?
Take him quiet, Marston.
Okay.
Get your hands dirty for a change. Jesus.
Okay, now what? We're at the perimeter. Okay, now what? We're at the perimeter.
Catch you unaware! coming back in the tank! Watch out!
Give us calm! This is done!
This is quite a hideout!
Come at me, you Irish bastards!
Okay, now what? We're at the perimeter. Okay, now what? We're at the perimeter.
Thank you.
turn and tear.
Leave him. Comb's still here. Leave him. Comb's still here.
Hey, he said Comb'd be in the cabin.
I'll check. You look out here.
What you got, O'Driscoll? They call to be in the cabin.
Thank you.
Comb O'Driscoll. He ain't here. You set us up.
Come here!
What? You set us up.
No, I didn't.
You did. Comb O'Driscoll ain't here!
He was here, I swear! If I was setting you up, I wouldn't have saved your life.
It's a good point, Arthur.
All right, then, go on. Get out of here.
Hey?
I won't kill you.
No, I didn't set you up.
Get lost.
Shit, lost.
I'm letting you run away. Now, go on. Get out of here.
That's as good as killing me. Out there, without you, Comb O'Driscoll's gonna lose his mind about this.
So?
So I'm one of you now.
Give me a break. All right, then. But I'm warning you.
Oh, hey, I know.
Come on, let's get to camp.
So you got the cash, then?
What cash?
Yeah, it's usually some cash. In the chimney.
I'll check it. Rest of you boys, get to camp, quick.
See, Arthur? I ain't so bad.
Hey, Bill. You tell Dutch old Kieran ain't worth killing. Just yet.
Yeah, right you are.
least you got something tucked away. Okay, boy. Let's go.
This ain't for you.
Calm down. They letting fools like you in the army now?
Hey, you going to get.
Or did you steal that uniform?
You do as you're damn told, all right? I'm on it.
Aw,
This is where I'm gonna let you suck.
Yeah.
time, boy.
You're making me uneasy. Back up.
Just calm down.
Hey there. Moment, please.
I ain't stopping.
Relax! I said stop, damn it. Yeah.
Thank you.
just my luck.
God damn it. Whoa, whoa. Easy. 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 It's okay. Easy. You're okay. It's all right. Whoa, now, easy. Come on, boy. Yeah. It's okay, boy. Let's go, boy.
Yep.
I don't mean no harm, okay? Just want to speak to Hernandez.
Well, we don't take the visitors up here. Kill this fool!
Flacco Hernandez? You in there? I didn't want trouble, but I'm just here to speak with you about Boy Calloway.
Put your weapons away! Or come out!
I'm unarmed.
Well, King Gallo.
I just want to talk about Boy Calloway.
Sure. Here's your message.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, boy.
Yep.
I just don't want him to see me. We're not friends anymore. We're not. They won't forgive you. They didn't forgive me. There is no forgiveness. None, friend. None. I know you want it. I can smell it on you. Well, it isn't happening. No, it isn't. That's why I'm out here, well away from them. They come for me, but I'm watching. I never sleep. I never do.
Hello, mister.
We got a long way to go, huh? I asked my boys here if they would help their pa build a new house. But I'd teach them a few things, you know. Couldn't hammer a nail to save their lives. Ain't that right, Curtis?
Whatever you say, Pa.
Look out!
What in the holy hell are you doing? Boy, get that back up again right now. I'm gonna be 100 years old by the time we get this done. No. Get away from it. Get away from it before you mess it up even worse than it is.
All the best.
You too, friend.
Why does he yell at us like that?
He don't like the way we're doing it. He should do it himself.
You know something?
You boys don't know your boy.
This is tough.
One night when I was frisky, them two was poking
surrounded by icebergs. Arthur!
Morning, mister.
You missing your tree yet?
I feel like chopping it down.
Watch from my pop was Pixar.
He's a picnic.
That ain't tough. See, sharks. That's a holiday.
No one looking after you, except
It's all just a miserable waste of time.
Appalling.
Dreadful. You know, maybe that's the point.
Mr. Arthur, I told Dutch, I feel I should tell you. I saw some of Colm's boys riding around.
Down here? What they want?
I have no idea.
They see you?
I don't think so.
Okay. Well, thanks for letting me know, Kieran.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Arthur.
Jose?
You want to go hunting?
What are you hunting? An elephant?
I wish. No, I saw a huge bear. One of the biggest I ever saw. I reckon nearly 1,000 pounds.
My God. But you need me to come with you.
Of course. Let's go.
Where are we heading exactly?
Up near the Dakota River. Might take a day or two.
I could do with a break from this place.
Oh, me too. It's been a rough couple of weeks. You need anything?
I don't think so. I got all I need.
Let's go then. So you still ain't replaced Boadicea?
Nah, I miss her. She was quite a horse. This one's okay, but ain't no Boadicea.
I've been meaning to offload this big Shire horse for a while now. Unruly bastard.
Where'd you get him?
Some big loudmouth bastard tried to rob me. I was out riding, so I... Well, you know how it is.
I see.
Let's take him to Valentine. It's on the way, sort of. There's a decent dealer there. We'll unload him. You could buy yourself a new horse. Put your saddle on him. Let's get going.
Okay. But I do kind of like this horse.
There's nothing wrong with two horses. And the stables always have the best ones.
I guess you're right.
This is gonna be fun, Arthur.
You won't throw me?
No, he's an angel, if I'm near him.
Nasty little look in his eyes.
Oh, don't be rude about this magnificent creature.
Okay, boy. Here you go.
Okay, see if you can get your leg over that brute. Come on, he's not that bad. All the time.
Easy, big feller.
All right, let's head into town. No bar fights, please. I heard about that.
I'll do my best.
We're heading... gone a couple of days. They got a good range of horse tack at the Valentine stables. Some beautiful saddles. I used to have a real nice one.
Yeah, what happened to that?
Got stolen outside that saloon in Deer Creek.
I remember now. Just about. That turned into a long day.
Yes. Remember? Mac went crazy. Threatened to kill the whole town. And Davey was passed out so cold we left him there. Came back in the next day and he woke up, started right back drinking again.
I'll miss those boys.
Jenny, too. She had some spot, that girl.
It must be pretty hard on Lenny. You could tell he was sweet on her.
Well, Lenny and Jenny could never have worked. That's like Arthur and Martha, or Bill and Phil.
Yeah, maybe you're right. Does feel a bit like our luck died with them, too.
Nonsense. We'll be all right. Just need some money to get back on our feet.
I hope so. You found a way to offload those Cornwall bonds yet?
Not yet. They're still very hot. Need to be done right. I have a couple of leads I'm looking into.
Morning, Brian.
Don't let that big bastard get the better of you there, Arthur.
He's all right.
Yep.
You're okay, boy.
Damn it.
Fine morning, partner.
Yep.
There, boy.
Stables are just up ahead. Watch it!
Come on, what's this
about? All right. Go sell that big brute and buy yourself a horse.
Okay.
I'm going off to the general store. Get a few things to lure that bear out with. Meet you back here in a bit.
Hey, how can I help you?
I'm in the market for a new horse. Something strong and fast.
Yeah, well, you're in the right place. I got some beauties in at the moment. Yeah. And what about this one here? Yeah, you looking to sell?
I sure you.
You got papers?
No. No papers.
Well, of course, that's going to affect what I can pay. But your luck's in. I got a fella who's been looking for a decent workhorse like this for a while. He'll pay a good price. Otherwise, I can always stable him here for you. Here, take a look. right, partner. You got yourself a deal. And a fine new horse.
I hope so.
Well, I don't sell anything other than good animals. You have my word on that. All right, let's see. Here are your papers. And on me, a new grooming brush. And some treats.
Appreciate it.
Yeah. All right, you. You treat this fella well. I know he's gonna look after you just fine.
Not bad, Arthur. You happy?
I guess we'll see.
Hop on up there, let's go. You won't know till you get in the saddle. All right, let's get going. We've got quite a ride ahead of us.
Lead the way. So, what's this lake we're heading for?
It's called O'Cray's Run, up in the mountains east of Cumberland Falls. I just hope I can remember how to get there.
Back into the mountains? I sure didn't figure on that.
But this time, we're doing the chasing. So how are things with you and John?
Fine.
Ain't it about time you let it go now?
It was a year, Jose. He ditched us for a goddamn year.
I've spoken to him many times. He knows he did wrong. He just wants to put it behind him.
I'm sure he does. Running off on that kid is one thing, but there's code. He knows that. He ain't Trelawney. Dutch and you pretty much raised him.
I know. But it's done. Has been for a while now.
Nobody else would have been welcomed back that easy after that long. And you know it.
Maybe. But please don't you put that to the test. Okay, I think we need to head right up here. Yes, I remember this place. Moonstone Pond. We're going the right way. That's the lake there. Good. We made it. Let's loop around the other side.
Where do you think Mike and Lenny got to? Susan sent them out scouting, but I figure they'd be back by now.
I have no idea. I hope they weren't picked up.
Why she sent Mike, I don't know.
He's effective in his own way. Lenny's got a good head on his shoulders.
Yeah, shouldn't have taken him this long.
No, but no point thinking the worst. Look there. Rabbits. Maybe we should catch one to cook.
Sure. Try and shoot one.
You don't want to use anything too powerful on a small animal like that. Just ruin the meat. Best thing's a bow or a .22 caliber varmint rifle.
I have hunted rabbits before, you know.
Yes. And obliterated them with a shotgun, if I remember right. Good job. All right. It's getting late. Reckon we should camp here.
Sure.
Well, then you... get us set up.
I'm famished.
Cook that rabbit, then. They're delicious on an open fire like this.
Fine by me. You want some of this?
No, I'm fine. I don't like eating this late.
Okay. After all that.
All right. Well, we better get some rest. I want to be up at first light to find this monster.
He better be worth all this drama.
Morning, Arthur. You ready?
Well, give me a minute.
Coffee?
Sure.
There you go.
So, what's your plan?
Well, we'll see if we can track him, but we might need to lay bait to draw him out. Bears like fish, obviously, but they also have a sweet tooth. A lot of fellas bait, then shoot from the trees, but I prefer to hunt on the ground. More dangerous, but we'll have a much better chance of getting a good shot in. And if he bolts, we can start right off after him. Can you mix up this bait for me while I finish packing this up? Fish, berries. I'll tie it up in that rag when you're done.
I hope you know what you're talking about.
I grew up in the... Arthur, I was virtually weaned on bear meat.
Okay, I think I got this done.
Good. Pack up and we'll get going. Pack up, Arthur, and let's get after it. Okay, let's go.
All right, girl.
We'll try our luck down by the water. That's where I saw him last.
Okay.
How's that horse treating you?
So far, so good.
You know, I was in this area with Bessie years ago.
Really? I didn't know that. I imagine you still miss her.
Every day.
Did you two ever think about getting out of the life?
We did briefly. You don't remember? Guess you were still young. Didn't last long. I drifted back into it. She understood. She knew what I was.
I remember you not being around for a while, but things were looser back then.
Truth is, there's never really any getting out. Staying in, it's hard. You know that. But Bessie and I made it work. Why? You thinking about getting out?
Me? No, of course not.
Listen, if Dutch's grand plans work, and we can make enough money to go someplace new, really new, maybe we can all have a new start. Anyway, for now, let's try and chase ourselves a bear, shall we? Let's look by the water here, see if he's been fishing again recently. Look for tracks, dung, bones, any sign.
Well, there's some paw marks here, Jose. They sure look big enough.
Good. Let's hope it's him. Can you tell which way he went?
This way. The tracks go into those trees. Wait a minute. Something on the ground here.
Half-eaten fish here. Must have been left by our friend, I reckon.
Come on, see if there's anything else. Something else on the ground, just here.
Well, take a look, then.
Air shit here. Watch your step.
Looks real fresh. Reckon he's got to be close.
Let's keep going. Damn it. Looks like here. We lost him?
For now. A little optimism, Arthur.
Well, what do you think?
I think we split up in each look.
Either that or we could place bait here.
That could work. Which do you think? Arthur?
Let's bait here.
Fine by me. Let's leave the bag over there. By those boulders up ahead, looks like a good spot for it.
Pounds, you say?
More or less. Big scar down his face. Hey, did that bait look okay to you?
I think so. You're the expert.
Ready with your gun there?
I'm good. You okay? Hey, you seem nervous.
So do you. I'm fine.
Sure.
Let's just take a look at that bait.
Sure. We only just said it, Jose.
your hand here. Got your knife? Shit. Easy. No, it's too close.
You're fine, old man.
Of course I'm fine. It's nothing. Nothing at all.
Thank you. I think. That was fun.
You know what, Arthur Morgan? I'm a little old and beaten up to be after the biggest game. You can have this.
What is it?
It's a map. A man in a bar gave it to me. Well, I stole it from him, but that's another story. He said it told him where to find some real big animals.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure. You saved my life, Arthur. I think I'm going back to camp to lick my wounds. You coming, or you gonna track that monster? Well?
I'm gonna stick around here for a while.
I'll see you back at camp. Yeah!
We got a trail. Ain't close. Must be close.
Hey, back!
Okay, girl.
What happened?
Oh, yes. Yes. Just lift as hard as you can. Oh, thank you. Thank you. You saved
sure.
me. Oh, that was bad.
Okay.
Sure. I could have been stuck here and starved or eaten. Oh, you poor, dumb animal. Oh. What'll I tell Mildred? Well, thank you.
You need a ride home, ma'am?
Oh, yes, mister, please. Thank you.
Let's go, girl.
I live over in Annisburg.
No problem.
Would you mind? There's not space enough for me on the horse.
Yo, this is too much for me. You'll need to find another way.
Oh. Well, fine then. Thank you for your help. Much as you did.
Yeah. Let's go, girl. Yeah.
Bring your skins and hides, both clothes, equipment, saddles, all made right here.
Hello, sir. First time here, I think.
Stay here for now, girl.
Okay, let's take a look at it.
Okay.
Quality hide makes the hardiest clothes around.
Don't doubt it. Ambitious type. If you want a unique garment, you need to bring me a unique pelt. It'll be worth it.
How's it been?
No complaints.
Well, that's nice.
I'd wager I can travel faster with this stall in tow than you or anyone can with nothing but a horse and a saddle. It's not about speed. It's about knowing the land.
Damn fine weather, ain't it?
Sure is good.
You must have heard of Tatanka, the buffalo down in Hennigan's Dead. Big as a stagecoach, twice as hard to kill. The one place to find them. A lot of folk want to apprentice under me. I got no competition. Why would I want some? Oh, the things I'd do if I had your youth. These days I'm fishing more and tracking less. My old man was right. Sneaks up on you. Right, let's see. All right, let's have a look.
waste your time painting this stretch. This here's all shit, and no shine.
You did good, girl.
Woo, this is the one. I can feel it. Yeah, here we go. Here we go. Hey, this here's my spot. Go claim your own.
Christ, relax, will you?
Show me some colors. Come on. What the hell is...
Hey, easy, girl. It's okay.
Not looking for trouble here.
Get the hell out of here.
Calm down. Maybe he can help us. It ain't like this is going well.
Really? Ah, shit. Nothing to lose, I suppose. Come on. The truth is, mister, our last batch of shine didn't turn out so good. You think you can help us with locating some ingredients? We could reward you for your troubles.
Could help. Happy to.
I saw some milkweed nearby. Milkweed's got these clusters of little pink flowers.
Happy to help and all, but this is odd. You know that, right?
Mister, you gonna find us some plants?
I changed my mind. This is pointless.
You're wasting our time.
Come on, the girl.
Yep. Now, come on.
You there?
Oh, hello?
You a bounty hunter?
Well, not right now, I ain't. You Black Bell? I'd like to talk to you about your Wild West days.
I don't care much for reminiscing. You got any friends as bounty hunters?
None that spring to mind.
Well, then you done led them boys here, and you none the wiser.
Ah, those bounty hunters.
Knew my luck had run out sooner or sooner.
Well, get inside. I'll tell them you're gone.
Oh, no, no. I ain't hiding from them scalp hunters. Not running from them, neither.
and fighting? Yeah, if it's just me against Sam, that'd be a waste of time and nitroglycerin.
Well, let me know what I can do.
You want that Wild West story, don't you?
Yes, I do.
All right. Get up here quick. Now, when I give you the word, hit that. Whole place is wired.
Black Bell, I got a contract here for your life or your liberty. We'd sooner it be liberty.
That's mighty reasonable, mister. Come here, let me take a look at it. Come on. Oh, come on. Stop just there. Now, send it out.
Them scalp hunters off your back.
For now.
For now. So, you gonna tell me about your Wild West days, running with Jim Boy Calloway?
Little Boy Calloway? The only running he did was away from a fight. And that's about the end of it.
Well, a man's apparently a famous gunslinger.
Yeah, so they say. But don't get what's famous confused with what's true. The ones of us that lived that life, we was too busy being scared for our scalp to talk to no newspaper writers or dime novel men.
Well, what were they like then? Those days they all talk about.
Same as now, I guess. Only longer ago.
All right. I'm gonna need your picture, too, if it ain't a trouble.
No, sir, no trouble at all. Can't be worse than those awful drawings on the wanted posters.
Hell, great. Look, you stand over there and let me get this thing ready.
Ready? How do you want me? Like this?
Okay, I got it.
Then I guess I'll be on my way.
Here. Well, thank you, Mrs. Bell. You gonna be all right?
Oh, been running for 20 years. Suppose I'll be running till I drop. Just the way it is.
Yep. Good luck.
Yep.
Thank you. proposition for you. Here it is. Fork over what you got. All right, hop on down, nice and slow. I won't ask again. Get down!
Oh, you dumb bastard!
Ah. Let's get her!
Ooh, a return customer. Oh, you need something exclusive, huh? What do you have for me? No questions asked. You got a decent eye for these things, by the looks of it.
Take care.
Yeah.
Greetings.
Hey, you there. A quick word.
What can I do for you, sir?
There's an old gunslinger I'm looking for. I heard he comes through here. Name of Midnight Billy.
Oh, that old soak? Yeah, he spends days on board these trains, but he's going nowhere but the gutter. I imagine you'll find him riding the next one through here. Either that or the next one. Try them both. Look in the bar car.
Mr. Midnight?
Excuse me, I'm trying to drink.
Mr. Midnight, listen, this won't take a moment. I just want to talk with you about your old days as a shootist.
Get away from me!
Hey!
I didn't shoot him in his sleep!
No one's saying
that... I didn't shoot him in his sleep, and if I did, it was the only way!
Not a problem. I'm here about Jim Boy Calloway, and no one shot him yet.
I knew you'd come for me! Get away from me!
Mr. Midnight!
Come on!
damn heat rat.
You boys don't run much, huh? Go drink some moonshine, yeah. You damn louts!
You stay off our land!
Hey, don't you, sons of bitches!
Get back here and fit out of the
stay,
way!
Girl.
Goddamn breakweights sneaking about here!
Move it, goddammit!
Who are you? What are you doing here?
I was just passing through. Don't mean to intrude on your politics.
Damn jackass.
You're all right, girl. Easy, girl. Giddy up.
Slow up now.
What business you got here?
Just minding my own business.
You better make yourself scarce.
I ain't here to cause trouble.
You want me to put a bullet in your skull?
Let's go, girl.
Yeah.
Hey there, friend. Come! Stop on by for a moment. The name's William.
Arthur.
You familiar with the study of plants, my friend?
Familiar ain't quite the word I'd use.
Well, let me tell you. This great earth beneath our feet can provide everything man ever needs. But we've only reached a tiny bit of its potential. You see, there are thousands, maybe millions of plants.
all across this vast country we share. The mountains, the plains, the swamps. I mean to explore them all. To know all of nature's bounty and all of her wonder, if I can.
Sure.
But I'm only one man. Would you consider helping me with gathering herbs for my studies?
Why?
Knowledge, kindness, beauty.
Well, I'm ignorant, ugly, and nasty.
Well, let's see if maybe we can do something about that.
I'll see.
I'm looking for a plant called yarrow. You can distinguish it by its red flowers. It shouldn't be too hard to find. They thrive out in the open under direct sunlight. Let's see how this tastes. Oh, yeah. I feel better already. They were right. This stuff does have medicinal properties. All this help, you deserve something in return. Well, save it for bad injuries. Heaven forbid your horse is in trouble, you'll be glad you had it. Now, if you don't mind, I'll be getting back to my studies. I look forward to our next meeting, traveler.
I can see why you do this. All the best to you.
Thanks, Arthur. And to you.
Been bringing in money?
Of course I have.
Okay, well, good.
All right.
Hey, Arthur.
Dandy, how are you?
Well, they haven't killed me yet.
Hello, Mr. Morgan.
Hi, Pearson.
Yeah, tough. They're good boys, mostly.
It's the most thing I'm scared about.
Mr. Morgan, bring me some materials, and I'll be glad to make something nice for you.
Keep my eye out for some good material.
You okay? Sure.
Hi, Karen.
Hello.
Mr. Morgan?
I'm not sad, just bored. You're bored? Bored's good. Bored means you ain't